Installing the TR6 is quick and easy. Let's take a look at a typical installation of a TR6 on an indoor A coil. First, pump down the refrigerant charge in the unit into the condenser or recovery cylinder. Next, disconnect the liquid line from the metering device and remove it from the system. If a piston is installed, as it was in our unit, be sure to remove it. Next, it's time to braze the outlet fitting you've selected to the TR6 outlet port. If the coil is equipped with a chat lift fitting that requires a Teflon O-ring, remove the O-ring prior to any brazing. In this case, our technician is loosely connecting the fitting to the distributor for stability during brazing. Be sure to wrap the body of the TR6 with a wet towel or use heat block paste to protect the internal components. Also, be sure to keep the sensing bulb and capillary tube away from the heat. After brazing the female connector, keep the towel in place while you sweat the connector to the existing 3/8 inch liquid line pipe. Remove the towel, replace the Teflon O-ring if equipped, and tighten the outlet coupling. Now the sensing bulb and equalization port can be installed. The sensing bulb and equalization line should be installed on the suction line after the header. This unit already has the 1/4 inch male flare access fitting installed. Connect the tube to an existing access port or make a suitable connection by either brazing a port into the line or installing a copper T. Never install the equalization tube on the bottom side of a horizontal pipe, as oil can clog this port. Now locate a horizontal section of the suction line and place the temperature sensing bulb on the top of the pipe. Locate the bulb between 10 and 2 o'clock position. Mount the capillary tube facing upwards using the patented copper strap included with the valve. Tighten the bulb onto the pipe. This will create a slight indentation into the suction line, which ensures excellent heat transfer. Completely wrap the bulb in all exposed ends with the insulation tape that is included with the TR6. This will ensure that the bulb is sensing the refrigerant and not any ambient temperatures. Now, with the TR6 installed, perform a leak check on all connections. After ensuring there are no leaks, you can properly charge the system, making sure there is the correct amount of subcooling. Finally, let the system run for 15 minutes for stabilization before checking the superheat.